Many people will observe tomorrow's anniversary of the terrorist attack on 9/11 by performing acts of community service. Among the groups coordinating those efforts in recent years is the nonprofit Boston Cares. The group also connects volunteers with a variety of projects happening year-round. To tell us about those efforts is the deputy director of Boston Cares, Sara Hamilton. Thank you very much for being with us, Sara.
Thanks for having me.
First of all, talk about the history of Boston Cares, because in a way that does have its roots in 9/11.
You know, we were really founded actually about 27 years ago by individuals who were looking for a way to get involved in their community without having to go through a lot of hoops, not make long-term commitments, really wanting to connect with their community and find a way to fit that in with their busy schedules. And so they founded Boston Cares as a flexible way to volunteer, that you can join us and then find a volunteer opportunity where it fits your schedule without having to commit to the same thing on a regular schedule, which is tough for people who have busy or changing schedules.
What kinds of things are you doing right now as far as volunteer projects? You're doing this year-round.
We do. We've got projects 365 days a year. We've got our flexible opportunities. There's about 200 of those every month that folks can choose from on our calendar. We also have a couple specialty programs we're running right now. One is our Allies for Immigrants program, which is a special tutoring program for individuals learning to speak English. We are a minority-majority city here in Boston. We have a lot of immigrants that are working their way towards citizenship, and volunteers are really needed to help practice English skills for those folks. And we also have a basic technology core that works with a program called Tech Goes Home, teaching really simple basic technology skills, like how to set up a Gmail account, to seniors, new immigrants, as well as youth. And students who go through this program actually earn a very low price, either iPad or computer, that they can purchase after completing the course. And it really goes towards furthering their education and economic opportunities. So volunteers can support that program as well.
So that sounds like really rudimentary computer skills, whether it's for the elderly or for immigrants. But this is not just, you know, fooling around. Why are those skills so important for people?
You know, these days, everything is online. So having an email address, knowing how to search for a job online is really important for new job seekers, as well as for parents. Think of an immigrant parent who might have a student in a Boston public school. Accessing homework, talking to teachers, things like that is all done online these days. So understanding how to do that really helps further both their children's education as well as their economic opportunity.
And I imagine for immigrants, unless you can do that and have an email account, you can't get in touch with your relatives in other countries around the world in an affordable way, at least.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yep.
What about the language instruction? Because some viewers may be saying, well, I don't know languages. I mean, how can I help?
Yeah. You know, the courses are a couple different varieties. One is you can support a teacher in a classroom where the teacher is actually teaching English and you are supporting one-on-one with a student that needs a little extra attention. Or we also have conversation groups, which is simply sitting around with a group of immigrants and having a conversation. You might be talking about what items they bought at the grocery store that week. But it doesn't require knowing another language. It just takes patience to be able to work through the conversations and practice words and sentences with those individuals.
And I guess we should explain, when people do that, they're really learning a lot. I mean, you can just sit there and be a good listener, and you're really doing them a big favor, isn't that
Absolutely.
The case?
Yeah, just that practice and that listening and having that trusted individual, that an immigrant who might not know a lot of people in the community, getting to know others and build those relationships is really important for them as well.
This is BNN News, and we're talking with Sara Hamilton from Boston Cares. Sara, looking further down in the calendar, I know Martin Luther King Day, that's another hotspot for community service. What are you working on for that right now?
So we're going to have a big day of service on January 21st. That's the Dr. King holiday. We'll have about 600 volunteers that are going to come out and actually make learning tools for our ESOL courses that we work with. So we're going to be making flashcards, some language games, all things that will be going to immigrant classes that we are working with through our partners with English at New Bostonians.
And you have a Family Volunteer Day coming up in November. What's going to be happening in that?
Pretty similar projects. We have a big, strong focus on immigrants right now in our work. There's a lot of need in our community for the immigrant support. And so Family Volunteer Day is the Saturday before Thanksgiving. And we're going to have some folks coming out to make some similar tools that we'll be doing on MLK Day. And both of those events are open to volunteers as young as 5. So it's a really great opportunity for folks looking to get their children involved. We also take groups. So if you've got a student group or a church or community group, these are great ways to get get them involved.
Now, I know we've been talking about tools and, and things that are useful, but what do you get from other people getting into contact with immigrants? I mean, there must be something going on there, isn't there?
There is. I think volunteering at its core is all about building community, getting to know people who might not be your immediate neighbor, or might not be in your regular social circle, but getting to know a broader, more diverse group of folks that make our city as great as it is. So building those connections for yourself as the volunteer to get to know those pockets of the community, but also opening it up to the immigrants that are learning to explore our city and know who's here as well.
Well, a little before you became a staff person at Boston Cares, you were doing volunteer work in this city. What did you get out of it?
You know, I met wonderful people when I volunteered. I built my own kind of community of friends while I was a college student in Boston, and that really meant a lot to me to get to know other people who had the same values that I did in terms of making our community a better place. And it also really gave me an opportunity to explore things off campus, places that I wouldn't normally go just for class, and get to know the city in a deeper way.
And of course, the other thing that people might be a little worried about is, you know, how much time do they have to commit? Are they locked in? Is there some way they can make this fit their schedules?
It's one of the things that's great about Boston Cares. By attending a one-time new volunteer orientation, we run about 12 of those every month. It's an hour in our office, and after that, you've got access to about 200 different opportunities every month that you can pick and choose what fits your schedule. We might see you at a food packing project this month, and you might take next month off, and maybe you want to tutor some adults after that. You can pick and choose what fits your schedule without having to make a long-term commitment to any one project.
Well, I know you've got a wonderful website with all these things in the calendar that people would be interested in doing. So if people want to find that, what's the best way for them to get to it?
Visit www.bostoncares.org. You can also email us at volunteers@bostoncares.org. We'd be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you very much for being with us.
Thanks for having me.
Sara Hamilton from Boston Cares.